Hey Montreal, hey sports fans, I'm Tony Marinaro, and you're watching Read Between the Lines with Adam Reed.
Mikael Kingsbury has been doing his best Ronda Rousey impression on the ski slopes. After his record-breaking performance, are we already looking at the Canadian Athlete of the Year? Gentlemen, welcome back. Seven back-to-back FIS World Cup Championships. He broke the record with 28 total. He's done it at 18 less events than the one who holds the record. Is he up for Canadian Athlete of the Year?
I don't see why not. I mean, I can't personally think of anybody else that can get that. I mean, you look at Eugenie Bouchard, she hasn't done as well. Mm-hmm. Milos Raonic, a lot of those guys will come into play. Haley Humphreys, I believe, won this award last year for bobsleigh. So, you look at a sport like
moguls. GSP's injured as well, so he's out of the running as well.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You look at a sport like moguls, and maybe it's not the most popular thing that you'll see on TV every day, but I mean, what the guy does day in and day out every single time he competes is he wins. And he has 9 more championships.
You're itching to get in there, Anthony.
Agree with you. I know you're making some good points. I have to go with Pretender on this one. I mean, he has medaled in the last 6 world championships, including 2 golds. He is 22 years old. But we all remember, or do we all remember Jean-Luc Brossard in 94, the Lillehammer Games. He won that medal in the moguls. He did a couple of McDonald's commercials, and no one ever heard of him again. So for him breaking all these records, I still don't see how he could take over the spotlight for Carey Price right now, who is, you know, arguably going to win the Hart, arguably going to win the Vezina.
Nick, I want to throw this question out to you because I think it's really important with, we talked about Carey Price. How do you guys feel with regards to professional athletes being intertwined with amateur athletes, right? With regards to the Canadian of the year, Canadian athlete of the year.
Right.
Do you think that that's fair? Do you think that pro athletes should have their own category and amateur athletes have their own?
I think that it should be separate because for hockey, they get exposure on a daily basis,
right,
versus for us, like track and field athletes, it's a cycle of every 4 years. So, you know, it's two different settings.
Do you feel that sometimes the accomplishments of those amateur athletes are overshadowed by, you know, you look at Sidney Crosby winning, you look at Wayne Gretzky winning, a few others, and chances are, you know, I hate to agree with you, but I really do believe Carey Price has a shot because of the season he's having. But ask me to put Carey Price versus Kingsbury in terms of what Kingsbury's been able to do, and considering the plateau he has, which is very minimal, like you were saying before, I think that's pretty impressive, and that's worthy of him to win it.
Everybody knows Alex Bilodeau. I mean, we saw Kingsbury in the Olympics, but everybody remembers Alex Bilodeau for doing the same thing.
Talk about clutch.
Right.
About clutch for Bilodeau. I mean,
exactly.
He comes through in the clutch.
And then you got to think that Bilodeau has 9 less world championships,
sure,
than Kingsbury.
Yeah.
You know, he's got 18. So then everyone started to wonder, like, you know, Kingsbury, he already made a splash a little bit in the Olympics, you know. Obviously fell behind, mm-hmm, Bilodeau, everyone's fan favorite, but now he keeps winning everything else.
Right.
I mean, he's got to get a lot more attention. I can't disagree with Carey Price. I mean, the season he's putting up is phenomenal. But at the same time, you gotta go with the guy who's playing by himself, you know. It's not like a sport with anybody else. It's all about him.
Right, but in all defense, though, in all fairness, Carey Price's individual numbers and what he's able to do and his save percentage, his Corsi, his Fenwick, I mean, he's the one that's handling that load all by himself.
Well, yeah, so the defense are there to help him as well.
Right, but the bigger chunk of it is how well Carey,
sure,
Price is playing. However, I'm more curious to know in terms of the validity of this award, right? You say Canadian Athlete of the Award. I'm just wondering if it's fair to kind of put Carey Price and Kingsbury in the same category when what Kingsbury's been able to do is bring attention to a sport that never gets the attention or the rightful respect.
The award is Canadian Athlete of the Year. Regardless if you're an amateur or professional, it shouldn't make a difference because it's Canadian Athlete of the Year. And I'm a team sports guy. I've always played team sports. I never participated in individual sports as Nick has done. But I believe that Carey Price carrying the Montreal Canadiens alone, he does have a defense in front of him. But how well is that defense playing knowing that Carey Price is going to stop every single shot coming there, plus the rebound? He's catching Martin Brodeur for most wins in a single NHL season. You know, his goals against average is under 2. He's, like I said, going to pick up some silverware, maybe even the Stanley Cup or a deep run. And right now, I mean,
if Carey Price gets injured tomorrow, God forbid, he misses the rest of the season, mm-hmm, does Kingsbury win the award?
No, I don't think so.
No,
I still think Carey Price can take that.
We'll agree to disagree. Gentlemen, it was a pleasure to have you both on. Thanks for taking the time. Jesse, I know you have a lot going on. You're a baseball guy. Huge things coming up in April for you, so we're looking forward to maybe having you back. But you're involved with a charity. I'd love for you to tell our people who are watching.
Right. I'm working. I'm going to be taking part in the fundraiser Curling for Kids. It's on March 28th, so we're raising as much money as possible. You can go on curlingforkids.com. Also on my Twitter, you can click on the link there and donate straight to my team that I have going. and all the proceeds go to children's hospitals. So St. Justin, Montreal Children's Hospitals.
Great initiative. We'll make sure to put that up on our Facebook page. Nick, thanks for taking the time. What do you have going on? I know you're working with the tracks and all sorts of different things going on.
Yeah, I operate a track club, finalpush.ca, and I help athletes improve their speed since it's something I studied for over a decade.
Thanks for taking the time for both of you.
Thanks for having me.
I really appreciate it. Thanks. Stay with us. My rant is up next. You don't want to miss it.
Read Between the Lines is brought to you by enconfiance.ca. Find your dream home.